YouTube analytics show that 88% of all of you guys have not subscribed. So make sure that you subscribe now. Back to the video. Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today, we're going to be making these Falcon goggles using just some simple materials such as cereal box cardboard, some sunglasses, binder material, and some basic materials such as tape and hot glue. For the colors, we're going to be using some simple materials like markers and some paint. So, before I start, I would like to mention that these goggles are two different types of goggles. One you can wear with this back strap that is from the Falcon and the Winter Soldier episode 6, where he wears Captain America suit for the first time, and this is from that. If you don't want it, you can always remove this and wear it just as the goggles. And this one will work as many Falcon goggles from the second Captain America movie or from the Avengers movies as well. And for the reference, I used this hot toys picture and some references from the show. So guys, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be taking these sunglasses. I've removed the lenses only for demonstration purposes. I'm actually going to put back the lenses in for my glasses. If you guys want, you don't have to put the lenses in. That will give you a little bit of a lighter red, but I want the darker red, so I'm going to put back the sunglasses lenses in back later. So we're going to take the binder material, and you see the glasses here. So we're going to trace this onto the binder material, and then we're going to cut it out. So what actually we're going to do is we're going to cut it out onto the book cover, like so. That will be the frame, and then we will transfer that onto the binder paper, and that binder paper will help as the lenses. Now I'm going to teach you how to pop the lenses out, like 1 and 2. I'm going to teach you that later. So these are the two lenses, so I'll just pop these back in and I'll show you how to pop them out. Just 1 second, let's pop them in. That's one. Make sure it's all tight. Okay, now this is the second one, and make sure this is all tight as well. Okay, so we gotta fit it in really perfectly, like make sure that it's completely lined up correctly, and there. Okay, so this is how the glasses look before. I'm going to put the lenses back in afterwards. So first you hold the middle, and then these lenses, like the middle part, you're gonna press them. These are plastic lenses, that's the reason I'm doing this, but if it's a glass lens, please take help of an adult. So that's one lens, and this is the second one, a little harder than the first one. There. Okay, yeah, so that's the second lens. Now this was the point in recording where I realized that I was going to have to put the lenses back in. So yeah, I'll be right back. So guys, I got that all figured out. I'm going to be using the lenses, so I'm going to pop them back into the glasses. I'm going to use them. So I have the binder material right here. I've cut it out, and I've cut it out to fit the glasses perfectly. If it's popping out a bit, you can just cut the excess. I'm going to be using RV29 Crimson. That's a Copic marker name, or Copic sketch, not Chow. So for Copic sketch it's RV29. I'm not sure if it's the same for Chow, it might be the same. So this is how the final product is. So I had cut a frame out of the back side of an old graph book, like the back cereal box cardboard kind of thing, but it's a little more flimsy than that. So I used this over here. So I just cut it out and I removed the middle part. So yeah, I only use the outside edge of it, like this black part. As you can see, it outlines the red, so it's come out pretty nice to finish. It looks quite smooth. Yeah, so we're going to have to add little more details, like the gold strap on the top of the nose area. So this is how it will look on the glasses, like it look like that. It's pretty bright,
and they can see your eyes through it. If you don't want them to see your eyes through, just put the lenses back in. It'll come a little darker, but that's fine. It's gonna look the same, pretty much the same. So yeah, this looks pretty nice. We're going to have to add the gold strap. So yeah, I'll just be back in a second. Here. So this is the gold strap that I was talking about. It's not gold yet. I have to color it gold. So I'll use Copic marker, like yellow and stuff. So it's gonna go over here. Like, just cut out a tiny piece and use it. So yeah, you can just stick it with Fevicol because it's just cardboard on top of cardboard, so it should fit perfectly. And yeah, I'm going to be using Copic markers. I'm going to be using the Y15, I think that's what it's called. And I forgot what the number of this is. I'm not sure. Yeah, so we're going to color it with this here. Okay, yeah. So I'm sticking it. I've colored it. And now it looks pretty nice. It fits in pretty well. You can see the reference images in the description down below. I'll link them down in the description below. And yeah, if you need any help in making this, you can ask me in the comment section. If you come across any problems, you can ask me those as well. So yeah, so I'm cutting out these unique shapes that go on the side of the glasses as a detail line. So yeah, I'm going to be sticking this, and I'm going to be coloring it black now with the Copic. Yeah, so that looks pretty nice. The shape fits pretty good along with the lenses. So yeah, it's fitting on to the glasses pretty nice. Yeah, so this is the lenses. Now the reason I'm using the lenses is, one, it'll look a little more like the Winter Soldier design, and two, it does not make much of a difference, you can see. So the bottom one is the lenses and the top one is without lenses, so it's not making much of a difference. And plus, it'll give the lenses a little bit more sturdiness, you could say. So it helps it stand a little more easily. So yeah, that's the reason I'm using the lenses. You can remove the lenses and not use them, or if you want it to be a little more sturdy, I would say go for the lenses. So to stick this, I'm going to be using hot glue. I'm going to be using a hot glue gun to stick it. Just put it around it and stick it onto the glasses. So yeah, I'll just be right back here. So my hot glue gun's heated up now a bit, and this is how I'm gonna stick it. It's not exact, like I'm not holding it exactly the correct way. Properly. Yeah, so it's pretty much gonna be like that in front, and the back is gonna just look like sunglasses. So yeah, let's hot glue. And so don't use a lot of hot glue, just use a little bit of hot glue. It should do the job. Like, use a thin string. Okay, mine's coming a little bit fat over here. Yeah, it came pretty big. So yeah, try to use small strings of hot glue and stick it onto your glasses. Mine came out pretty big. It's not supposed to come out that big. But yeah, if you want to make sure it's completely sturdy, you can add glue generously, like how I just did. So press it down, let it cool down for a while. Once it's cooled down, it'll be all ready. You can wear it. So you can stop the video right here if you wanted to, and you can just wear these Falcon goggles for what they are. You can just wear them as Falcon. But we're going to be doing the Captain America part coming up in the video, so it's just going to be the back side of the head, like the back piece. So yeah, stick around and I'll show you that as well. So yeah, it's popping out a bit. I can add a little more hot glue in the corner. So I will decide whether I need to add more hot glue, or it can just stay like that. If there's any excess popping out of the glasses, like the middle area, you can cut that off as well. Yeah, okay, now it's coming out a lot. So I need to hot glue it properly. There you go. Okay, so that seems better now. Seems way better. So yeah, you can test out the glasses by wearing them. The vision shouldn't be too hard. Like, it won't hurt your eyes or anything like that. As far as I know, it was perfectly fine for me. It was just like a red tint. So yeah, it's pretty good. You can wear them and see them. Yeah, they're pretty good. Yeah, they look, I mean, they just look a bit red, like when you wear them. So, yeah. So, I'm going to paint the sides now, and I'm going to do the back of the neck area. So, yeah, stick around for that, and I'll show you how to make that as well. But, see you guys later if you just want to see up to here and stop. Yeah, so let's move on to the next step. Okay guys, so I'm gonna open my phone for this one. Yeah, okay, so I've opened up the falcon image. So you can see this is his cowl. That's what they call it, it's like a cowl. So it goes and attaches to his neck, but I obviously can't make that with cardboard since it'll make it really itchy. So I'm gonna be using this. It'll go around your ears and these parts will just hold the glasses in place. So these will go right here. Let me just hold this down. So it'll go right there, like onto the glasses area, like that. So you wear it and it'll just hold it in place. For sticking the parts, use hot glue gun or use some Fevicol. So one second, I'm just gonna keep this aside. So this is pretty simple. It's the middle of the ear area, so I just trimmed the edges a bit. I cut a bit of the edge, so yeah, you can just trim a bit of the edge and use it as the over ear glasses part. Yeah, so this is basically how I cut it. I trimmed the edge off, like I trimmed this edge off. I you can just throw it away, don't need it. And use this part over here, just flip it over and stick it. Now this is how it looks. So it's working fine. So you can wear your glasses and this will hold your glasses in place like this. Let me just show you. So you gotta put your glass in here like that. So you gotta wear the neck piece and then you have to wear your glasses. You can't put the glasses like this and then wear the whole thing, because your head won't fit in. So this is where your ears will fit. So it's small and the shape looks a little different. That's because your ear is going to be sticking out of it. So you can just fold your ear a bit, push it through and then just leave it, and then it will just stay outside of the ear area of this behind the head cardboard piece. And it's pretty comfortable, so it's not going to hurt your ears or anything. If you really don't want to take any chance, then just add a couple of sponges around that area on the inside so that it doesn't hurt. Now we are going to be adding this extra detail part right here. So cut this out of the same material that you made the back neck piece out of. Now you're going to stick it on here. You can stick it on with hot glue or with double sided tape, with any material that you want. Make sure it's just strong. Make sure it's strong. You want it to stay on, because it will give it a little bit more detail, or else it's just going to look really plain and it's not going to look very nice. So yeah, I'm going to be using double sided tape. It's pretty sticky, so it should stay in place. the back of this. Now let's just bend it a bit to make sure so that it won't come out, and it will just stay in the same shape when you wear it. I'm talking about the detail for this. So the detail part won't come out when you're wearing it. So just bend it a bit around the edge, around the edge of the table, or by your hands itself. So we're going to paint now. To keep these aside. So just get my paint. So first, please get the glasses. So these are the glasses. Okay. So we're going to paint the sides of these as well. Just this part. Both the sides, because there's this Spider-Man sticker on the side and we don't want those to be seen. So this is the inside part, so we don't have to paint that. I'm not going to paint it. If you want, you can paint it black or white itself. That's if you want. But I'm just going to paint the outside, and I'm going to paint the side of the glasses. So let's start. So for this I'm using Camel acrylic paints, and we're going to be needing only a few colors, like 3 or 4 colors. So white, then we need black obviously. So first we need the blues as well. So Prussian blue, then this blue, I think cobalt, yeah, it's called cobalt blue. And yeah, we need black as well, but then that black is over, so I'll see which black paint I have and I'll use that. So I'm going to put this into the palette. If I don't have black paint, I'll just use a black marker and I'll do the parts that I need in black with that. So I'm going to be using a reference right here. There's a lot of references on Google. Just search one of them up and use those as reference. Or you can just copy mine. Wrong picture. Yeah, okay. So this is the design. I'm going to, there's not really much image of the back side of his head. So I'm just going to be using from whatever I have. So I put down a newspaper. Since this is a wood surface, I can't just paint directly. So I'm just gonna paint it on a newspaper. Paint it white. This part is Prussian blue. Along with these as well, paint a Prussian blue strip on the top. Yes, I realized it was cobalt blue that I painted the strip. It's not Prussian. Make sure you paint it with cobalt blue. So I used a piece of cardboard to make it straight, and now the ears. I painted over them just to make sure that even the inside edge of the ear part is painted, and no spots are left empty. Now it's time for painting the glasses and the extra details on this. So let's paint the extra details first. So I'm painting the extra details around the ears, adding on to the fat strip with the cobalt blue, and a middle tiny strip on the detail, and then some Prussian blue on the side of the fat blue strip, the cobalt blue strip. Now, we've painted this, it looks pretty nice. It doesn't look exact right now because I've not removed it off the newspaper. But once I remove it off, it'll look nice. So I'll just keep this aside. One second. I'll just keep this here. Now we're gonna have to paint the glasses. So we're gonna paint those cobalt blue as well, since it'll look a little bit better. I mean, in the show it was like a grayish blue, but I want it to be cobalt blue. You can paint a grayish blue if you want. So yeah, let's start painting. Start clearing up my area, and I'm going to move all of these to let them dry. Also start clearing up your area and let these dry by themselves. Don't touch them for at least 1 or 2 hours to make sure that they're completely dry. Leave it like this. I'm leaving them on top of it. So it's painted, it's looking pretty nice. The colors are very vibrant. So let's just leave it here. I'll see you guys after like 1 to 2 hours. And this is a list of materials that I used. So if you are planning to make this, then here are the materials. If you do not want to make this and you just wanted to watch the video, then yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure that you like this video. Comment down below what you would like to see next. Share this video with your friends and family. If anybody likes art or likes to make different items like crafts and stuff, and also subscribe if you haven't already. Okay, all, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.